application to hydrogen-like particle. Application of quantum mechanics and Schrodinger wave equation to hydrogen-like particle. First of all, we need to know what is meant by hydrogen-like particle. Hydrogen-like particle means any particle which has only two particles, which is a two-particle system. Two particles, one must be electron and other is the nucleus. All the protons, neutrons in the nucleus are considered to be one particle because they are quite close together. In short, if we talk in terms of atom, any atom which has only one electron is hydrogen-like. For example, hydrogen, helium, He positive, Be 3 positive, lithium 2 positive. The Schrodinger wave equation for hydrogen-like particle is the normal Schrodinger wave equation, curly square phi and so on, E minus V. As you have seen till now that the difference in the Schrodinger wave equation for a different system is only in the potential energy. So we will put potential value of potential energy accordingly, which you will see soon. Where M stands for mass, V is the potential energy, E is total energy, X, Y, Z are the coordinates of the particle. For hydrogen-like particle, we don't use mass. We use mu, reduced mass. And reduced mass is, you know, M1 into M2 over M1 plus M2. Here M1, one mass is mass of the electron revolving around the nucleus and other particle is considered to be the nucleus itself. So the reduced mass will be Me into Mn over Me plus Mn. Since you know mass of the electron is very negligible as compared to the mass of the proton which constitute the nucleus, protons and neutrons which constitute the nucleus, therefore Me is very very less than Mn. Therefore this can be neglected here. When we neglect this, we can cancel this and mu is equal to Me. Taking only revolution of electron around the nucleus. We take only revolution of nucleus, electron around the nucleus to find a simple expression for the potential energy. So for electron revolving or moving under the influence of force field, what is electron? Electron is a charged particle. Any charged particle which moves under the force field, the potential energy is given by minus Z into E square over R, where Ze is the charge on the nucleus, minus E, that is opposite, is the charge on the electron, and R is the distance between the nucleus and the electron. This is electrostatic force and all that, electrostatic potential. So now substituting the values of V and changing the coordinates to polar system, we get this equation. Here you can see minus V becomes plus Ze square over R, and this all conversion you have seen earlier also. And there this equation is like this. Separation of variables. Now we can see three variables in this equation. One is R, other is theta, and other is, third one is phi. To separate the variables, we write the wave function as a product of three different functions which depend upon one variable each. R, theta and phi are independent of each other. This is the short form. Differentiate this equation. We differentiate this with respect to R, theta and phi different times to substitute these values. To get different derivatives required in equation 6, for example, here we require d phi over dr. So we will differentiate this with respect to R. We also require d phi by d theta, so we will differentiate this with theta and so on, and we will take those values and substitute in this equation. This is what we obtain. Here we want to see, this is one complete term, second and third. We want that in one term we have only one type of variable. Like here, we have only R, capital R and small r. We don't want this. So to solve that problem, we multiply throughout by R square and divide by R, theta and phi. So here if we multiply by R, theta and phi, this will get cancelled and we will get capital R and this will all go and so on. So you can see that after doing this step, this term only include R, this term only include theta and phi. So writing, so this term contain only R, that is the radial part, and these two terms contain both theta and phi, that is the angular part. Writing radial and angular terms on different side. This is the radial term, this is the radial term, and this is the angular terms. So the radial terms is equal to angular terms. So this equality, as we have already done earlier, is equal. This equality holds good when both these are individually equal to some constant. Say that constant is beta. So thus putting the radial part and angular part separately equal to the same constant, we get this. This is equal to beta, and this equation is equal to minus beta. This was the radial equation, this is the angular equation. But here we have only variable r. Here we have two variables, theta and phi. So to further separate the terms of theta and phi, you have to remove this sine theta here, then it will be only left with phi terms. So what we do, we multiply by sine square theta. So we get this. Taking this term on this side and this term on other side. So this side now only has sine terms. This has only phi terms. Theta terms, and this has only phi terms. So again, each side, these are equal only when they are equal to some constant. Let that constant be m square. So this is equal to m square and this is equal to m square. So means this part is equal to minus m square. For hydrogen-like particle, if we solve all this equation, which is not solved here, the final result is that beta should be equal to L into L plus 1, where L has value 0 or any integral values or any integer. L, that is, L is equal to 0, 1, 2, and so on. Now we have expression for angular spherical wave function. Phi m is equal to 1 over under the root 2 pi e raised to pi r iota m phi, where m is 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus till L. The value of m varies from 0 to L. First it starts from minus L to 0, then 0 to plus L. This is the term for theta. L m is equal to minus 1 raised to pi m under the root 2 L, and so on. So product of these two different, this is one function, this is other function, product of these two function is angular wave function. This is known as spherical harmonics. Expression for radial wave function, R is the radial part of the wave function. Then R is equal to n raised to power e minus L by 2 p, and so on. So n is the normalization constant. It is given by this formula. Then p is this and this and so on. A is a constant defined by this. Where L is the associated Legendre polynomial, and so on. You can see all this. Now expression for the energy for hydrogen-like particle. From all these, expression for energy is found out to be minus 2 pi square mu z square e raised to power 4 n square h. And the value is found out to be 13.6 z square n square electron volt. The quantum number from Schrodinger wave equation. Now one important result of solving all this quantum equation for hydrogen like particle is to solve Schrodinger wave equation, it is first separated into three equations, each in one variable, that is r, theta and phi. Each is then solved to get the expression for the function r, theta and phi. The expression for the function involves three quantum numbers n, l and m. That is, this is a wave function which depends upon n and m, n, l and m. Then it is separated into three wave functions r, theta and phi. We find out that r depends upon the value of n and l, theta depends upon the value of l and m, and phi depends only upon the value of m. It is found that the solution of Schrodinger wave equation obtained in terms of expression for r, theta and phi are acceptable only if they follow the restrictions obtained, restrictions about N, L and M, such that N is an integer starting from 1, value of M varies from 0 to N minus 1, M varies from minus L to 0, then from 0 to plus L. What does this means? This means that if we need to solve the Schrödinger wave equation, first of all, we have to separate into three different functions which depend upon one variable each. Then after solving, we will get many, many solutions for the wave function, but only those wave functions are acceptable which follow these restrictions, which follow these restrictions on N, L and M values. Only those solutions are acceptable. This also means inverse. Inversely, it means that only these values of N, L and M are possible. So N can have only integral values starting from 0. L for a particular N can have values from 0 to N minus 1, and M can have value from minus L to plus M including 0. These values of N, L and M are exactly same as those for the principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum numbers respectively. Thus, these three quantum numbers follow from the solution of the Schrödinger wave equation. These values are same which we have studied. So it is now proved that these are obtained from Schrödinger wave equation.